What a joy it is to welcome all of you here today to worship at Cross Baptist Church. And we're excited to have some special guests with us today. It looks a little different around here, and that's a good thing. And I'll introduce those in just a moment. But if you are a guest with us today, we want to say a special welcome to you. There is somewhere near you in the back of the pew in front of you, there's a little card that looks something like this. It's called a connection card. And we just want to be able to connect with you. We want you to know how much we appreciate you worshiping with us today. We want to be able to welcome you. So if you wouldn't mind, give us a little information about yourself. And then on the way out today, the offering plates are out in the foyer. We haven't been passing the plates as kind of we used to before the COVID and all that. But on your way out, just drop that in the plate. If you have a special prayer request that you would like for the pastor to be praying for, on the back side of that card, mark pastor. It'll say pastor only, and that will get to my desk. I want to be praying for you. I want to pray for your needs, and we need to pray for one another. So be sure you fill that out and drop that in the plate so it will get to me and I can be praying for you. We are so glad today to have our guest with us. This is Voices of Mobile. And just by way of introduction, this is my alma mater. I am a graduate of the University of Mobile, or back in the day, Mobile College. And there may be a face in this group that some of you Calvary folks will recognize. Because Josh, where are you? Josh is almost a spitting image of his daddy. Is he not? I knew I'd embarrass him with that. But anyway, Wes Bell was such a great friend to me. We were college buddies, played flag football together and did everything together. And we go out and we preach at the churches around the area together. And Wes and Lauren were such dear friends. In fact, we both left Mobile and moved all the way to Fort Worth, Texas, and where Shannon and I met at University of Mobile. And Wes and Laureen met at University of Mobile, and they married, and then Shannon and I married, and we all moved out to Fort Worth and went to seminary together, and just we loved Wes and Laureen. And so what a joy it is today to have Josh with us and this group. And I won't say a whole lot more because they're going to bless your socks off if you've got them on today. And so I'm excited to hear from them today. But let me pause and have a word of prayer, and then we're just going to turn it over to Voices of Mobile. Father in heaven, what a privilege it is to be in your house today, to worship you, to express our love for you, to gather together as you've called us to be together because we are better together. And Lord, what a joy it was to preach on that very issue last week, a week ago, and be reminded that you've called us to be a family. You've called us out of this world and the darkness of it. And we look at all the things going on around us in this world, and we know there's a better way. There's Jesus' way. And thank you that you have called us to Jesus' way. So thank you, Lord, that you have gathered us in this place. And we are looking for not just a blessing and to be entertained, but God, we're looking to gather together to worship. And this group behind me, we know, is here to lead us to your throne of grace. That's the purpose, that's the goal in all of this, that you would be glorified. And Lord, that you would touch our hearts, that when we leave this place, we're not the same as when we came here because of the Holy Spirit's transforming power. Lord, do your work in us today as only you can, work from the inside out. We love you, and we thank you, and we praise you for all of these beautiful gifts that you've given. And we thank you for the opportunity to now worship together with music and song and the gift of glorifying your name. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you. Josh will be the first one to do it. And I'm not just saying that, I really mean it. so I know for many of you, you probably witnessed that in the West all those years ago, and it lives on in Josh. And so we're excited to be here. We're excited to be here with Josh. But more than anything else, we want a couple of things to happen this morning. We want, first of all, for you to have maybe a little bit more fun than you thought you were going to have. I don't know what you were expecting when you walked in here this morning. You got no clue who we are. And we know we sing a lot at the top because we know what people are doing. The strangers come to the church. We know exactly what's happening. You just need some time to look them over and pick out the one you like the best. That's what you're doing. And you're thinking, well, I wonder why she wears her hair like that. You're thinking, boy, he sure is skinny. I wonder if he ever eats. And the answer is, yes, I do eat, but I appreciate you being concerned about that. But we know that's happening. But I want you to notice, we ask Pastor, please leave all the lights on. Because we're just doing you the same way. We're just going to do our own. So that's all that's happening. Isn't that fun? Isn't it funny when that happens? So we're just so blessed. But we want you to have more fun than you thought. And second of all, we want you to worship with us. I like to say, we're not here to worship for you. We're certainly not here to worship in your place. Your job this morning as we sing, whether you know the songs or not, is to worship along with us in your hearts. So as we sing these songs, glorify the name of our Lord Jesus with us, and that will make it be a truly blessed morning. All right, fellas, why don't you come out? We're going to let the guys sing their song. I wasn't planning on doing it, but because of this whole Josh thing, I guess we'll let the guys do their song. Now, the guys, I don't know how else to describe the guys, but they are just, they're just a bunch of goofballs is what the guys are. They're just goofy, and they're really kind of funny. Are there any Southern Gospel fans in the house?
Yeah.
Okay. Do you know what a Gaither homecoming is? Okay. This is nothing like that. Nothing like that. But it's a Gaither song. It's kind of fun. Cedric's going to sing it. And I really kind of like the title of it. It reminds me of my childhood. I grew up in Thomasville, Alabama, if anybody knows where that is. And my granddaddy, all the time, I'd ask my granddad, his name's John, and I love him dearly. I'd say, granddaddy, where can I find some water? And he'd say, over yonder. And I'm thinking, granddaddy, you understand, that gives me no information, granddaddy. Yonder is everywhere. But if you're up in Alabama, in the South, we know exactly where yonder is. And that's the title of this song. It just says, I'm going up yonder.
Face to face, whoa, whoa, whoa.
Forever sitting at the feet of Jesus, worshiping him with all of God's creation, with believers, with brothers and sisters in Christ, with angels, with saints who went there a long time ago, and all singing, a thousand generations singing, "Forever he shall reign. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty." We're going to sing that together with one voice. That is incredible. So whatever else may happen, at least we know we'll spend forever glorifying our God and our King. We're going to sing one final song, and the pastor's going to come, and he's going to close us out. Before we do that, I want to say thank you. Thank you for worshiping with us this morning. Thank you, Pastor, for having us. Thank you. Where's Josh? Thank you, right here. Thank you, Josh, for existing. Thank you, Jennifer, for here. like I said, we do this every single weekend, and you know, whenever we have breaks, we take tours. So like when all the other students go home, they keep working. You know, that's kind of what we do. So this summer, for example, in May, we'll leave on May the 20th, and we will come back on June the 15th. So about 26 days straight on a bus. And we're gonna drive to Texas. We're gonna sing in Texas in some places, and then we're gonna drive to Tennessee, and we'll sing in West Tennessee. And then we're gonna drive to Illinois, and we'll sing in Illinois. And then we're gonna drive to Michigan. We'll sing in Michigan. Then we're gonna come back through Illinois and sing in Iowa, and then in Nebraska. And all of this is headed towards the culmination of a concert that we have the opportunity to see out in front of Mount Rushmore. The National Park Service has invited us to sing, and so us, along with about 100 voice choir, are going to be singing out in front of Mount Rushmore. So that's kind of the, you know, it's kind of crazy. If you ask my bus driver, he didn't like it too much. It doesn't make sense. Mobile's here, South Dakota's here. But we're going to go. It kind of makes an hourglass because then we got to come all the way back to Mobile. So that's the plan for the summer. And the Voice of Mobile has always been responsible for raising all of our funds as we travel. So I tell you all that to say that if you would like to support us as we travel, a lot of people ask if they can help. You can do that through our product table, which is just out these doors and to the right. Our ladies will be out there afterwards, and there's a bunch of CDs out there. I think there's like 6 or 7 CDs total. There's a couple t-shirts. One of the t-shirts just says "Going Up Yonder" on it, you know, if you like that song. That's on there. And then also, importantly for you, we just recorded a brand new album, literally just a couple weeks ago. And the title of the album is No Ordinary Worship. There's a song we didn't sing this morning. That's kind of the title of the album. But really, there's a subheading underneath that album, and it just says, Josh Bell and the Voices of Mobile. That's what that album is. And so you can actually pre-order that album out there as well if you'd like. You can order it now, we'll get your address, and we'll ship it to you. So that's how you can get that album. All the CDs are $10 a piece. You can get any 3 for $20 or every single thing you have on the table for $50. And if you pre-order the album, we'll just throw in an extra $5 just to help us with shipping. But anyway, you can do all that out there. And if that would be something you'd like to do, that would be a big blessing for us. We want to sing one final song before Pastor comes, and Lexus is going to sing it. Lexus, this is her 5th year traveling with Voices. Typically, you only get 4. Lexus stuck around. She had an extra semester, so we're like, hey, you know, graduate in fall, just keep traveling with us in the spring. We'd like to keep you. You kind of find out a lot when you hear her sing the song. And, you know, I wish you knew the stories of all of these students, but particularly somebody like Alexis. For me, this is my 9th year traveling with Voices. I started traveling back in, I think, 2013, 2014, and actually, Eufaula was the first city that we came to. My first concert that I sang with Voices back when I was a sophomore in college was at First Baptist Eufaula. So I'll never forget Eufaula because it was the beginning of a very, very important time in my life, traveling with the Voices of Mobile. But getting to watch people like Alexis grow up is one of the greatest privileges that I have now on this side of it. My wife and I work alongside each other. I like to tell people she's the reason they sound good, and I'm not really sure what my job is, but she she teaches them all the music and all that kind of stuff. But we'd love to get to work with these students. And so you'll love to hear Lexa sing a song called Alabaster Box. Thank you.
Yeah.
I'll take just a minute to share something with you. What you've heard today, you've been blessed by. There's something about the harmonies that God has made us in such a way that we enjoy the music. Because it's something that pleases Him. You see, we're made in the image of God for a reason. We enjoy the things that God enjoys. And He fills up our souls with the joy of the sounds that we've heard today. But there's something else. It's not just the melody, and it's not just the harmonies that have been sung today. It's been the Word of God. And I want to share with you, and I promise, buddy, I'm not going to preach, but I just can't help myself sometimes. Psalm 33. Psalm 33. You've got to hear this. Rejoice in the Lord, you righteous ones. Praise from the upright is beautiful. Praise the Lord with the lyre. Make music to Him with 10-string harp. Sing a new song unto Him. Play skillfully on the strings with a joyful shout. But get this. All of that music was leading up to one thing. And what was that? The very next verse. Verse 4 says, for the word of the Lord is right. And all the works are trustworthy. All of this has been a culmination to point to the one thing that's more important than everything, Jesus Christ. The Word of God tells us that He bled on a cross. He died for our sins. And they took His body off that cross and they put it in a borrowed tomb. But the good news is He didn't stay there, did He? On the third day, He rose again. And in just a few weeks, on Easter Sunday, what a glorious day that's going to be. But here's the thing. My friend, my good friend Wes, is already getting to see that glory that one day we'll behold. But Wes can only do that because Wes put his faith in Jesus Christ. Yes, he was a preacher of the gospel. Yes, he was a great friend and just a good guy. But none of that was the most important thing. It was that he knew Jesus Christ as his personal Lord and Savior. He was pastor to Calvary, and so many of you heard his messages week in and week out for several years. And I know you were blessed by that. But I know if he were here today to tell you, he would say, what I'm saying to you, give your life to Jesus if you don't know him. If you don't know Jesus Christ, you've got to know him so that you can be where I am, that you can have a home in heaven. The beautiful songs we've heard today about heaven, the glory that will be. But if you don't know Jesus, you want to experience that glory for yourself. And that's what we want you to do right now, today. I'm going to ask you to bow your heads. In just a moment, we're going to pray and we're going to close this out. And as the group sings, I'm going to invite you. If you don't know Jesus Christ as your own Lord and Savior, today's the day. Why would you wait another second? Just between you and me and the Lord, would you say, Pastor, I don't know. I wish I knew, but I don't know that I know Jesus as my own personal Lord and Savior. I want to pray for you. Would you lift up a hand and say, Pastor, pray for me. I don't know. And I want to know. I desperately want to know that I have a home in heaven. Would you just lift up a hand and put it back down? Thank you. If today you would say, you know what? I know I have a home in heaven. I have a relationship with God. But you know what? I can't say it's really what it needs to be. It's been a long time since I've had that close connection with Jesus like I know I should. You know, today's the day that all of that could change. Jesus is always just as close as our prayer of repentance. Lord, forgive me. I've tried to do this on my own, and all the time, all the while, you've told me that you've got this. And I want to turn to you. In repentance of my own sin, I turn to you. Forgive me. And cleanse me from all that unrighteousness. If that's you today, would you just lift a hand and say, I need to get close to Jesus again. I want to walk with him every day. We just raise a hand and say, Lord, this is me. That's me. I need you. I need you today. Thank you so much. If you need Christ in your life today, you're invited to come and respond. Let's stand together. If you need to place your membership together.